The imperial noble consort Shujia was Qianlong's third imperial noble consort. But when she was alive, her highest rank was noble consort. One day after that, she was posthumously promoted to the imperial noble consort and was buried in Qianlong's Yuling. Shujia originally was from Baoyi family, and her last name was Jin. She was Manchu, but her ancestors were from Korea. Now, how her ancestors arrived at China had different versions. In Qin and Jin clan's records, Jin clan lived in Yizhou, which was located in today's North Korea. In 1327, the Emperor Huang Taiji's time, Jin clan voluntarily came to China and surrendered to Qin. But in Korea's records, in 1726, Qin conquered Yizhou. The army killed all people who didn't surrender. In this situation, Jin clan surrendered and came to China. In 2019, a researcher published a paper about Jin clan's life in Qin. In this paper, Asher mentioned Jin clan was deeply influenced by Manchuria culture. In daily life, they used Manchuria language. Because of blood, Jin clan had a close relationship with Korean emissaries and gave them some advice on political issues with Qin. Like the imperial noble consort Hui Xian's family, Shujia's family was Baoyi, but had important positions in government. In 1746, 2 years after Shujia became the consort Jia, her father San Bao was seriously sick. The noble consort Gao's father, Gao Bin, begged Qianlong to give some rewards to San Bao. So it's reasonable to say Gao family and Jin family had great relationship, and the noble consort Gao and the consort Jia, highly possible, were best friends. Jin Shi married Qianlong as Gege before the Empress Xiaoxian. During this time, Qianlong seems didn't like her very much, because when Qianlong inherited the throne, Jin Shi only got a title of Gui Ren, the noble lady. 8 months later, the noble lady Jin was promoted to Jia Pin, the noble concubine Jia. 3 years later, the noble concubine Jia gave birth to Qianlong's fourth son, Yong Cheng, who was the first son of Qianlong, became the emperor. But the noble concubine Jia didn't be promoted. Until 2 years later, she got the consort title. In beginning 1745, the noble consort Gao was promoted to the imperial noble consort and passed away. The consort Xian and the consort Chen were promoted to noble consort at same time. The consort Jia became the fourth highest rank consort. In 1748, the Empress Xiaoxian passed away. The noble consort Xian was promoted to the managing inner court imperial noble consort. About 4 months later, near consort Jia's due day, Qianlong promoted her to the noble consort Jia. 8 days later, the noble consort Jia gave birth to Qianlong's ninth son. Unfortunately, this boy died at one without name. In 1751, Qianlong moved the noble consort Jia's family to Manchuria Plain Yellow Banner, and the noble consort Jia's last name was changed to Jin Jia. In 1755, the noble consort Jia passed away and was posthumously promoted to the imperial noble consort Shujia. Shujia totally gave birth 4 boys for Qianlong. Except the 3rd boy, all other 3 boys grown up. In 1763, Shujia's first son, Yongcheng, was adopted by the prince Lü Yi of the first rank and had no chance of inheriting the throne. Shujia's second son, Yongxuan, had like problem. So, except all his brothers passed away, he had no chance to become the emperor. But Yongcheng got his father's longevity DNA and passed away at 86. Shujia's 4th son, Yongxing, was a talented boy and once was favored by Qianlong. Yongxing was married with Empress Xiaoxian's niece, but Yongxing was too messy and lost his father's favor. Thank you for watching this video. See you soon.